không nghe vậy.
Madam Chair, the seven neighborhood schools that received no secondary one posting from MOE this year were attributed to the falling cohort size. Indeed, the 2015 cohort of 38,600 secondary one students is about 10% lower than the previous year. However, if MOE were to divide the 2015 cohort size by the number of secondary schools, it can easily fill all schools, including these seven schools, with at least 5 to 6 classes of 40 students each. Thus, the reality is, all schools are created not equal, as popular schools will continue to attract more students at the expense of neighborhood schools. This called into question about the mantra that every school is a good school. The mad rush to become a parent volunteer, join the RC, or even relocate just to secure a better chance in the balloting exercise for admission into popular schools for their children has become a stressful ritual for parents year after year. So in the minds of parents, every school is definitely not the same. But what do teachers and principals think? I'm sure when teachers and principals come together, the issue of funding for their school will surface somewhere down their conversation. It is my belief that MOE must walk the talk that every school is indeed a good school by addressing the funding issues first. In a reply to my PQ on the funding for school, the minister said it is not meaningful to compare funding per school, but rather we should look at the per capita funding per student. Madam, I believe comparing funding per school is meaningful because we are talking about every school is a good school at the school level. So while we know that every student can be a good student because they are given the same per capita funding, I'm not sure if every school can be a good school in the context of funding at the school level. Popular school with higher enrollment numbers by default will have more budget to work with. This, in my opinion, creates an unlevered playing field for less popular schools. I shall confine my speech to primary education to illustrate this point. Let us compare Roseside Primary School with an enrollment of 2,000 students with Bendemeer Primary School with an enrollment of 1,200 students. Based on per capita funding per primary school, Roseside Primary School is effectively receiving $7.8 million more than Bendemeer Primary School every year. This disparity is significant and needs to be addressed because smaller schools will always face a budget constraint by default. This disparity will perpetuate year after year as popular schools with bigger budget will be able to do more for their students and at lower cost due to economy of scale. And when schools churn out even more top students, it will be a hard sell to tell parents that every school is a good school because neighborhood school will be shrinking in size and disappearing over time. Madam, we are living in a social media world. We do not need the mainstream media to publicize anything anymore. The popular school will get more popular through the grapevine. Does the minister not agree that it makes a world of difference for principal and teachers of smaller neighborhood schools to have comparable amount of funding as those popular schools to run their program each year? For less popular school with smaller cohort, the extra funding will come in handy to compensate for the lower economy of scale in the procurement of products and services for the student. This school will also be able to do more in sports and enrichment program, which I strongly believe are important activities for neighborhood school, small neighborhood school, to build character and instill a sense of belonging and pride in their students. I urge the ministry to release such funding data so that all stakeholders can have a meaningful discussion over this mantra that every school is a good school. Next, I wish to suggest a fundamental change to the secondary one posting in the context of every school is a good school. I propose that graduating student finishing in the top tier of their primary school based on PSLE result to be given a direct admission to secondary school of their choice. Currently, primary schools are already recognizing their top PSLE students. So the chances of top students from neighborhood primary school going to popular school like Dunman High, Hwa Chong or Raffles Institution are no lesser than their peer from popular primary school now and still based on merit at the school level. This will ensure a good mix and spread of students from all spectrum of primary school going into the secondary school. This will also prevent elitism from entrenching itself in the feeding primary school and the popular secondary school. This new posting exercise will make every primary school a good school as the top graduating student in each school will have a direct entry to a school of their choice. For parents who want their children to attend a popular secondary school, every primary school is a good school to start the journey now. Thank you, Madam.